Hello, and welcome to the Exponential Smoothing tutorial series. In this tutorial, we'll introduce the latest addition to the Exponential Smoothing Functions family, the General Exponential Smoothing Function, GESMTH. The General Exponential Smoothing Function not only supports prior smoothing models covered by the simple, double, and triple exponential smoothing function, but it implements additional types for trend and seasonal components. Furthermore, the general exponential smoothing supports data prior transformation and Chatfield adjustment for the first order autocorrelation in forecast errors. In short, the general exponential smoothing function is the ultimate tool in our arsenal to exponentially smooth your data and project forecast. In this video, we'll cover the smoothing models of a seasonal and trending data set using the different trend and seasonality types and built-in optimization for the smoothing parameters. For data, we'll use the monthly net power generations in the U.S. using natural gas between January 1989 to March 2017. The data was sourced from U.S. Energy Information Agency and units are expressed in millions of megawatt hours. Examine the data over time, along with a 24-month moving average, and let's draw a few observations. The time series is definitely exhibiting annual seasonality. Although the ups and downs in the signal are changing over time, the time series doesn't suggest a relationship with levels. In other words, the level increases and peaks and troughs are not changing accordingly. And the power of the net generation is growing approximately in a linear fashion. Now we have an idea of what we're dealing with, so let's begin. For illustration, we list the input arguments of the general exponential smoothing function in cells D1 to D11. So select the cell D18. Type in the function name GESMTH in the cell or in the equation toolbar. Note that the autocomplete feature of Microsoft Excel will help you find the correct function. Once you find the general exponential smoothing function, click on the FX button located on the left side of the equation toolbar. This will invoke the function arguments dialog box for the general exponential smoothing function. First, let's specify the input cell range, and then lock the starting cell reference by pressing F4. In the order field, specify 1 or true for the time order in the series. This designates that the first observation in the input series corresponds to the earliest date of our time series. For the level smoothing parameter alpha, you can type in a value between 0 and 1. Leave blank or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D1, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the trend smoothing parameter beta, you can also type in a value between 0 and 1, leave blank, or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D2, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For gamma or seasonality indices smoothing parameters, you may type in a value between 0 and 1, leave blank, or reference an existing cell in your worksheet. For consistency, let's reference the value in D3, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. Now, for the trend dampening coefficient phi, you can type in a value between 0 and 1, leave it blank, or reference a cell in your worksheet. Let's reference the value in D4, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the parameter value of Chatfield's autocorrelation correction term, also known as lambda, you may type in a value between negative 1 and 1, leave blank, or reference a cell in your worksheet. Let's reference the value in cell D5. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For trend type, you need to choose a value between 0, which would be no trend, to 4, which is damped-multiplicative. Leave blank, which is no trend, or reference a cell in your worksheet. We're going to reference another cell. This cell is D6. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For seasonality type argument, you may leave blank, indicating none, enter 1, or reference a cell in the worksheet. For consistency with the rest of the arguments, let's reference the cell D7, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For seasonal length, you may leave blank, indicating no seasonality, type in a value, like 12 for monthly data, or reference a cell. Let's reference the value in cell D8, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For enabling or disabling the built-in optimizer, you may type in true, leave blank, or reference a value in a worksheet. Let's reference the value in D9, and then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For enabling or disabling Chatfield's autocorrelation correction, enter true or false, leave blank, or reference a value in cell D10. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For prior data log transform, reference the value in cell D11. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the forecast time, we will be forecasting the value at the end of the input data. So set T to 0, or better yet, reference the cell in column A so we can change it after the end of the input data. And then lock the cell for column movement by hitting F4 until the dollar sign is showing at the left. For return type, leave blank or type in 0 for forecast. Then click OK. The function returns NA since we don't have enough data. Copy the formula to the cells below it, even after the end of the sample data. Don't worry about the empty cells picked up after the end of the input data. The function will ignore them. Before we can compare other smoothing models, let's quantify the forecasting accuracy of the new series. For this illustration, we will use three forecast performance measures. For absolute measure, we will use mean squared error. For percentage error, we will choose the symmetric mean absolute percentage error. And for a relative scaled error, relative to a seasonal naive model, we will use the mean absolute scaled error. These functions are a part of NumXL and are available as worksheet functions. First, let's examine a no-trend model and new seasonality, also known as Brown's simple exponential smoothing. Set the trend type to 0, indicating no trend, in D6, and seasonality type to 0, in D7. Leave the value in D8 intact, as the general exponential smoothing function will simply ignore it. The worksheet auto-calculates all of the values, and the plot reflects the new series. It does not look very good, though. Looking further to the forecast accuracy measure, MASE states it performs worse than a plain naive forecast, about 29% worse. MAPE shows that the average percentage error is around 14%. Before we can examine these seasonal models, let's decompose the smooth signal and forecast into level trend and seasonal indices to better understand the fit of each model. Copy the formula in D18 to cell E18, and then select E18 and press the FX button. Change the input cell range to cover all inputs from cell C18 to C356. Press F4 to lock the whole cell range. Change the forecast time to a value that equals to the number of steps for our forecast beyond the end of the input cell range. For our illustration, we are forecasting 41 months post-March 2017. Then press F4 to lock the cell. Finally, change the return type from 0 or blank to 6 for a level component. Then click OK. The function returns NA, and this is okay as it is the first value in the array. Now, starting from cells E18, select all the cells up to E397. Press F2 to edit the formula, then press Ctrl, Shift, and then Enter. This will populate all of the level values. Repeat the same steps for trend and seasonal indices in column F and G. Notice how both series return NA, as we don't have the trend or seasonality specified in the model yet. Plot the level, trend, and seasonal indices in your worksheet. Okay, let's add an additive seasonality component. So set seasonality type to 1 in cell D7. Again, the worksheet recalculates all forecast values and the graph is updated. It looks better than earlier, so examine the accuracy measures. MASE shows it performs better than a naive model, about 31% better. MAPE shows a better average of absolute error, moving from 14% to 8%. Let's examine the forecast. The forecast seems to fit the data okay, and the out-of-sample forecast looks somewhat low. So let's examine both the level and seasonality components for stability. The seasonal component looks stable over the duration of the sample and the forecast time. The level component is a bit noisy, but this is a good start. Now, let's include an additive trend type into the model, so set the value in D6 to 1. Once Excel recalculates the worksheet, let's examine the results. MASE has improved and MAPE remains the same at 8%. Let's examine both level and trend seasonal components for stability. The seasonal component looks stable over the duration of the sample and the forecast time. Trend and level look noisy. Nevertheless, this is an improvement. How about a dampen additive trend? So change the trend type in D6 to 2. Once Excel finishes recalculation, let's examine the results. MASE got worse, actually 3% worse than the earlier one. Let's examine both the level and seasonality component for stability. The seasonal indices component exhibit variations over the duration of the sample and the forecast time. This is not good. Trend converges to zero and stays at zero after that. Level is a bit noisy. This is not an improvement. Change the trend type back to additive, so set the value in D6 to 1. How about a multiplicative seasonality? So set the seasonality type value to equal 2 in cell D7. After the worksheet completes its automatic calculation, notice that the accuracy measure, MASE, got worse. And also examine the components and notice the seasonal indices variation throughout the sample. This is not an improvement either. Set the seasonality type to additive by setting the value in D7 to 1. Now, let's attempt to use the log transform for the data. So set the value in D11 to true or 1. After the worksheet calculation is complete, notice that the accuracy measures, MASE, got better, 71%, while the MAPE is back to 8%. Examine the components of the series. Level looks a bit noisy, but seasonal indices look stable throughout the sample and the forecast. Now, let's try a Dampen additive trend. So set the value in D6 to 2. The accuracy measure did not change much, but the out-of-sample forecast is not trending. There is one more parameter we have not used so far. That's Chatfield's correction. Chatfield's correction for first-order autocorrelation in the model's forecast values. Let's try to use it. So set the log transform back to false, or 0, to disable it. Then set the trend type back to additive, so enter 1 in cell D6. Set the Chatfield's correction adjustment term to true or 1 in cell D10. Once the worksheet finishes recalculating, notice how the MASE and MAPE have both improved significantly. This is great. Let's examine the components. Level and trend look noisy. The seasonal indices are stable. Also, let's examine the out-of-sample forecast pattern. The model projects a change in general levels going forward. How reasonable is that? A subject matter intuition is key here. Let's assume we disagree with the model earlier, so let's choose a different one. So set the trend type to multiplicative by setting the value in D6 to 3. Wait for the worksheet recalculation to complete and then examine the output. The forecast accuracy remains at the same levels. MAPE is 7% and MASE is 62%, which is good. The level and trend component are relatively smooth and stable. The seasonal indices vary throughout the sample, but they're stable. And the out-of-sample forecast projects a growth in the general levels. Can you combine log transform with Chatfield's correction? You bet, but we'll leave this to you to experiment on your own. NumXL takes out all of the number crunching heavy lifting so you, the subject matter expert, has the time to exercise your intuition to filter through the different alternatives and arrive at the one that makes the best sense. In this tutorial, we only looked at general exponential smoothing as one time series with one seasonal pattern. Many time series found in practice exhibit several distinct seasonal variations. For instance, for power demand, there is weekly, daily, and seasonal patterns. Furthermore, we have not included any extraneous factors like fuel price level, available power generation capacity, etc. That's all for now. But check back with us later and we'll have updates and enhancements to our smoothing models. Thank you for watching.